Hi everybody, this is Dr. Murphy from Digestive Health Institute, Oasis City, Kamalath, Lower Perel. I'm going to speak to you today about metabolic syndrome, diabetes surgery, whether it's good value for money and whether you should be doing it. Diabetes surgery, up till now people thought that most people who had high sugars should not get operated. And today surgeons across the world have called bariatric surgery and repositioned it as metabolic surgery to treat your diabetes. Your high sugars, to stop medications like insulin and various other things. So how does this transition occur? Well, years back, something which was called as bariatric surgery, which is actually meant for weight loss and people who were very obese, surgeons realized that suddenly their sugars came under control, their cholesterol seemed to come down, their hypertension got under control. And therefore the three main prongs of metabolic syndrome or syndrome X, which is diabetes, type 2 diabetes essentially, hypertension, and cholesterol or dyslipidemia, all three went away. And that's how the surgery started being Christian from bariatric surgery into metabolic surgery. Now we do know that weight causes a lot of problems across the world, right? So weight causes problems on your body right from head to toe. So from intracranial hypertension to things like thyroid problems to things like respiratory problems like sleep apnea and right-sided heart failure, left-sided heart failure. It causes problems in the stomach, which are like hiatal hernias, gastroesophageal reflux disease, gallstones. The biggest form of cirrhotic livers today is non-alcoholic steatohepatitis or NAFLD, which is non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, all because of obesity. Then you get pancreatitis, you can get large amounts of hernias because of obesity. We do know that infertility is linked directly to obesity. Lots of pain like osteoarthritis as well as gouty arthritis because of high uric acid levels. So all these things are caused by obesity. Today 40 different types of cancers are directly linked to obesity. So in men there is higher chance of prostate cancer and lung cancer. In women there's a much higher chance of uterine cancer and breast cancer as we speak. So prevention they say is the best form of cure. But what happens when you're morbidly obese, or when your BMI in India is more than 37.5, or it's above 32.5 and you persevere uncontrolled diabetes? Today, most of the conservative associations across the world, such as the American Diabetes Association, the International Diabetes Federation, have all said that if your sugars are not getting under control with medications, at best, you can give metabolic surgery or bariatric surgery a chance. What happens with some of the currently available drugs? Well, they're getting more and more expensive, that is to begin with. And what happens is that invariably you can't stick to good sugar control because of the currently available medication. So invariably a chronic diabetic would have the vessels of his heart, his eyes, his kidneys, and the peripheral vessels leading to diabetic nephropathy, which leads to kidney damage and leading to renal transplants. Or you can have heart failures because of diabetes, or you can have blindness because of diabetes, or you can have gangrenous foot or loss of sensations on your foot, which is called a diabetic neuropathy. The best way to prevent this today is to get cured with metabolic surgery. So at best, within the 10 to 15 year period of the onset of type 2 diabetes, you can get it. What happens in type 1 diabetes? Well, type 1 diabetes, bariatric surgery does not cure. But if you are really obese and taking a lot of insulin with type 1 diabetes, then maybe you should give bariatric surgery a chance. Reduce your weight so that your insulin content comes down and your overall complications come down. So for all those who want to get in touch with me, consult me, seek an appointment, please do consult me through Lybrate.com.